All right, so welcome back everyone to another video. Tone here. So this video will talk about the Eastern Conference playoff prediction. So I'm going to talk about the play-in game tournament, and after that, you know, the playoffs. So if you haven't checked out the Western Conference, I also have a Western Conference playoff prediction as well. So please check that out after this video if you haven't checked it out yet. And if you haven't subscribed, please do. It'll be much appreciated. And let's get started. All right, so let's start with the play-in games. All right, so first is going to be the Sixers versus the Heat. I'm going to take the Miami Heat for the upset. So that means the 76ers, they're going to have to play another game. The Sixers, I know they won 8 in a row, but Miami's been playing well too. And they got Tyler Hero now. And I think Rozier should play this game as well. I don't really trust Kyle Lowry and Buddy Hield that much. I still think Miami has the best bench in the NBA with Kevin Love, Jamie, and Duncan Robinson. And I think Jimmy Butler, like, I know this is quite a long time ago, but I still think Jimmy Butler kind of have that, you know, history with the, you know, with the Sixers, you know, the whole Tobias Harris thing. And I think Jimmy Butler is going to show up in this game, right? I think Jimmy Butler is going to love kind of just like, you know, beating the Sixers fan, you know. And I don't know if you guys gamble or not, but if you do gamble, put Jimmy Butler over on points on Wednesday, because Jimmy Butler is gonna go over in points. So I'm gonna take the upset. I'm gonna take the Heat. All right. So the number 9 and number 10 seed, you have the Bulls and the Hawks. Atlanta is just embarrassing. They just give 157 points to the Pacers. I know the game didn't mean that much, but can you play just a little bit of defense? The Bulls, they gave the Knicks a tough game overtime. So I'm going to pick the Bulls to win this game. You know, the Bulls are at home. And all right. So, all right. So next we have the 76ers and the Bulls. I'm going to take the 76ers, the home team. I think Joel Embiid's going to have a big game. And they're going to fit. And it's not really much for me to say. Like, the Sixers are just better than the Bulls. So I have the 76ers as the number 8 seed. All right, so let's start with the Eastern Conference playoffs. All right, so let's see the playoff matchup. All right, so the number 1 versus the number 8 seed. You're going to have Boston versus the 76ers. I'm going to choose Boston in 6 games. I do feel bad for Philly. You know, Joel Embiid missed a lot of games. They don't have that much chemistry with some of the new guys like Kyle Lowry and Buddy Hield. I feel like Philly, you know, could have a chance to upset Boston if Joel Embiid play like the last 10-15 games, right? Just to have the chemistry. Boston's been pretty healthy, right? You know, so, you know, they have a lot of chemistry with one another. You know, they're first place. And so I'm gonna choose Boston in 6 games. You know, Joel Embiid's probably gonna win Philly 2 games, right? He's gonna have those 40 points, 12 rebounds, you know, 3 blocks. So I don't think it's enough to beat Boston. I'm sure Maxey's gonna do well too, but I think Boston is just too good right now for the 76ers. So Boston in 6. All right, so next we have the Cleveland versus the Magic. I'm going to take Cleveland in 7. This is going to be a very close series. Both teams play good defense. But the Magic, you know, this is the first time in the playoffs like in 5 years, right? They're going to have... they just don't have enough experience to beat the Cleveland, right? I think Mitchell's going to, you know, play really well in game 7, and you know, he's gonna put up some big numbers, right? And I you know, Banchero, right, this is his first playoff, you know, he's probably gonna make a lot of mistakes, right? Might force some shots, you know, some turnovers, because, you know, Cleveland is probably gonna plan, you know gonna plan around him, right? And it's gonna probably frustrate him a little bit. Yes, you know, it's just his first time in the playoff, right? So he's gonna, you know, make some mistakes. But again, it's still going to be a very close series, but I'll take Cleveland in 7. All right. So the number 2 and number 7 seed, The Knicks versus the Heat. I'm going to take the upset. I'm going to take the Miami Heat. And, you know, I feel bad for the Knicks. The reason why I am taking the Heat over the Knicks is because of, you know, Julius Randle is injured. You know, like, I like OG a lot. He's probably going to shut down Tyler Hero. But right now, a lot of people will probably think that, you know, Jalen Brunson is going to, like, outperform Jimmy Butler. But remember, this is the playoff now, right? And Jimmy Butler, you know, they call him Jimmy, you know, playoff Jimmy for a reason, right? There's a reason why, you know, the Heat are, you know, either in the Eastern Conference or in the NBA Finals, right? Eastern Conference Finals or the NBA Finals, right? Because it's mainly because of Jimmy Butler, right? He turned it up a notch, right, in the playoffs. And part of me think that he's probably going to outplay Jalen Brunson in this series, right? I think he's going to shock the world a little bit. But another reason is that why I think I'm picking the Heat is because I don't know who's going to guard Bam, you know? Hartenstein and Mitchell Robinson and Precious, like, these guys are decent NBA players, but they can't guard Bam, right? They need Julius Randle to guard Bam. And it is unfortunate that, you know, Julius Randle is injured. And, you know, he's not going to, you know, play in this NBA, the NBA playoffs. But if they had Julius Randle, I would have picked the Knicks over the Miami Heat. But that's not going to be the case. And part of me think that, you know, like I said, right, Jimmy Butler is going to, you know, outperform Brunson. He's going to shock the world. And I think Bam's going to have an amazing series, right, because they have nobody to guard him. So I'm going to take the Heat in seven, right? The series will still be close. Brunson will still make his shots. You know, the Knicks have good role players. They play hard. They play defense. You know, they chase those 50-50 balls really well. But I still think the Heat's going to upset the Knicks. All right? So next we have the third and the sixth seed. It's going to be the Bucks versus the Pacers. I'm going to take the Bucks in seven games. The Bucks should be embarrassed that it, you know, I think most of us would think, like, the beginning of the season, right? The Bucks and the Pacers, if they match up in the playoffs, you know, most of us would probably pick five games, right? The fact that it's going to take seven games for them to beat the Pacers, you know, it's a little disappointing. The Pacers are 4-1 against the Bucks in the regular season, so that is something, you know, to consider. But I think I believe in Giannis a lot. I think Giannis is, you know, a superstar. And I think he will be the best player on the floor still, right? You know, his free throw is probably going to be a little problem, but I think they're going to win Game 7 at home. I think Dame's going to make some big shots down the stretch for them as well. And they're going to squeeze it out, right? And I have the Bucks in 7 against the Pacers. All right, so let's start the second round. So I'm going to choose Boston in 5 against Cleveland. There's not much Cleveland can do to beat Boston. I think Boston, you know, their starting five is just so much better than Cleveland's starting five. Boston will be at home. Boston will have the best player on the floor in Tatum. And, yeah. There's not really, you know, much to say in this series. I think Boston will beat Cleveland pretty easily in five games. All right, so the Bucks versus the Heat. I'm going to take the upset. I'm going to take the Miami Heat. I think Miami's, you know, the last 3 weeks, right? I think Miami's outplayed, you know, been outplaying the Bucks. The Bucks, they have, you know, they've been struggling. You know, Miami beat them last season, right? You know, without Tyler Hero. You know, but Giannis missed some games too. But, you know, Giannis did play more games than Tyler Hero did last season, right? The Heat won. I think Miami, like, it's just a bad matchup for the Bucks, right? Because, you know, they have Bam, right? They can kind of build the wall against Giannis with Bam and Kevin Love and you know. So, and with that Jokic kid as well, like they can cause problems for Giannis, right? You know, with the whole wall stuff. And, yeah, so, and Jimmy Butler is going to guard Dame. And I like the Miami bench better than I like the Bucks bench. Right, I know I said this before, but I'm gonna say it again. I think the Miami Heat has the best bench in basketball, right? You know, with Kevin Love getting rebounds for them, and he can still make threes. You know, that Jamie kid, you know, he plays really hard. He hustles for those 50-50 balls. And, you know, Duncan Robinson can get hot, right? He can easily score 10 to 15 points for the Miami Heat coming off the bench. So, yeah, I think Eric Spoelstra is a better coach than Doc Rivers, right? You know, let's not forget this. Doc Rivers, man, he has a problem coming, you know, getting out of the second round, right? You know, he struggled to get out of the second round with the, you know, the 76ers and the Clippers, right? So, yeah, so I'm going to take the Miami Heat to beat the Bucks. All right, so you have your rematch from last season, Eastern Conference Final. I am going to take the Miami Heat in seven games. This is going to be, like, I know Boston is 4-0 against the Miami Heat this season. But, you know, one of the games is, like, in early October, right? Like, most of us agree, like, October games probably don't really matter. One of the games, you know, Terry Rozier just, you know, got to the Heat. You know, Jimmy Butler didn't play. I think most basketball fans who've been watching the last five seasons knows that if Boston, Miami, when they meet up in the playoffs, it is close, right? Like it doesn't matter what the regular season record is, right? When they're playing in the playoffs, you know, these two teams are so evenly matched. But what I like most about, you know, I think Miami's going to win this series because, you know, they didn't have Tyler Hero last season. They still beat the Boston Celtics. I know Boston Celtics added, you know, Drew Holiday and Porzingis, but I think Terry Rozier is kind of their secret weapon. I think a lot of people might not realize it, but I think that's the one of the reason why they brought Terry Rozier over to Miami, right? Because they want him to, you know, because Miami knows that Boston is the team to beat, right? And like we match up, we're gonna have Terry Rozier, right? And Terry Rozier is gonna have a chip on his shoulder, right? Because Boston did trade him to Charlotte. And I can see Terry Rozier making some big shots against Boston, right? Like those dagger threes to kind of to win the series. So it is going to be evenly matched. It's going to go seven games, but I think the Heat is going to squeeze it out, and they're going to make it to the NBA Finals again. All right, so this pretty much included the video, guys. If you haven't watched the Western Conference video, I'm gonna leave it in the description so you guys can check it out too. You can see who I picked to win the West. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do. It'd be much appreciated. And I'll see you in the next video.